This video is going to be split up into a few different sections. First, I'm going to be talking about my weight and all of the struggles that I've had with that throughout my life. And then I'm going to be talking about the different health issues that I've had. Finally, I want to talk about where I am now with my health and then where I hope that I'll be in the future, because I'm definitely not finished with my journey. Starting with my weight. I've really struggled with my weight for most of my life. When I was 5, I was at a really healthy weight. I was a very, very healthy looking girl. But when I was 8 years old, a few things started happening that made me start to gain weight. One was that my family got cable around that time, so I just kind of became more lazy. Two was that I loved canned pastas. I still do, but I was like addicted to them and I would eat them whenever I could. Same with like McDonald's, any kind of junk food, I was on it. And then the third thing was that I was molested. I ended up keeping it a secret for 3 years, and those three things combined just ended up being a perfect storm of sorts. And I ended up starting to gain weight. And this was at a time where kids weren't necessarily overweight like they are these days. It was kind of the beginning of everything. And so there weren't really clothes options. I remember going into the clothing store, and I just wanted to be a normal little girl and dress in the cute little clothes, but I couldn't fit into them. So I would have to shop in the women's section sometimes. And it was really, really hard on my self-esteem and my mental well-being. So I struggled with this through my preteen years and my teen years. And I remember just always feeling different. By the time that I was 20, I had reached my heaviest and I was almost 220 pounds. I just decided that I really wanted to kind of take care of myself because I didn't take care of myself at all. If you look at pictures from me back then, I just didn't care. I felt like I was ugly. I felt like there was nothing good about me. And I honestly felt that if I could just lose weight, it would take care of everything. I would suddenly love myself completely and everything would be perfect. And I want to make something clear. 220 pounds was very hard for me. I personally didn't like myself at that weight, but there's lots of people who weigh more and they look beautiful. And there's people who weigh less and they don't look very healthy. So I am purely talking about my personal experience at that weight. Well, over the next year, I ended up losing almost 70 pounds and I felt really great about myself. I ended up getting into a relationship, and as a lot of people do when they get comfortable in a relationship, they start putting on some weight. I ended up losing a lot of it, but the relationship was not healthy. It was very abusive, and when I got out of the relationship, I ended up having to go on antidepressants. There's a lot of stigma regarding mental medications, and it's really unfortunate because sometimes that's the best thing for someone. I was on the medications, and within a few months, I gained about 40 pounds. I don't think that this was only because of the medications. I was in a very bad place in my life, and so I was eating a lot. But I ended up gaining back a lot of the weight that I had tried to lose, and I just started feeling bad about myself again. The thing that I really struggled with throughout all the times that I tried to lose weight was that I wasn't really caring about how I was doing it. As long as I was going down on the scale and my clothes weren't as big as they used to be, that's all I cared about. And so for all I would have cared, I could have done an all sugar diet, but kept it within the allowed calories for that day. I did not care about how I was losing it. And so this was really bad for me because it kind of was a no-win situation. I got really good at losing the weight, but I was terrible about keeping it off because I didn't have any kind of system in place to actually help me to succeed. And that was the case until I found the Mediterranean diet. When I started the Mediterranean diet, I ended up losing the weight that I had gained, and I just started feeling a lot better. Now, this video is not a way to get you to do the Mediterranean diet. I am planning to do a video on that, but just having any kind of diet that is sustainable and is something you enjoy is really important. Now that I've talked about my weight, I want to tell you about the struggles that I've had with my health. When I was 16, I was diagnosed with gallbladder disease, Crohn's disease, and then a few years later, hypothyroidism. This was a struggle for me because with Crohn's disease, you never know when you're going to actually have an episode and need to use the bathroom. And this was always a fear of mine that it was going to happen when I was in the middle of class and the teacher was not going to let me go, or I was going to be embarrassed because people were going to know that I needed to use the bathroom. Not only was I having to deal with the pressures of being overweight, I was also having to deal with having a chronic illness that was also separating me from those around me. It alienated me and made me feel like I just was different from everyone else. Then when I was 19, I was diagnosed with, as I mentioned, hypothyroidism. And this was another thing to just kind of add on to everything I had to deal with. A few more years went by and I ended up going to see a spinal doctor. My back really hurt all the time. It always felt really tired and I was just in a lot of pain. So I went to a spinal surgeon and he diagnosed me with a condition called Scheuermann's kyphosis or Scheuermann's disease. And this is a rare spinal deformity. It's kind of like scoliosis. Scoliosis is going this way, while kyphosis is going the other way. And so I essentially had a hunchback. The vertebrae get wedged because of trauma to the spine, or it can happen during puberty, and then it creates the hunchback effect. I was devastated when this happened because I had been so hopeful that all I would have to do is go in there and he would have me do some stretches and some different exercises, and maybe after a couple months, I would be all better. That wasn't the case. When I went in there, I still had to do the stretches and the exercises because he didn't want to give me a spinal fusion because I was so young, and if the exercises and all that were to help, then that would be great. But they ended up not helping me. When I was 22, I ended up getting a 14-level spinal fusion from T1 to L2. This was a really big procedure and it changed my life from that day forward. Once again, I had one more thing that just made me feel like I was different from everyone else. And this was something that definitely made me different from people. Not too many people have that kind of hardware in their body, but it really did help with my mental well-being. A few months later, I got into that abusive relationship that I mentioned. And after a couple years being in that, I developed fibromyalgia. I believe that it happened partly because of the surgery that I had, because that was very traumatic to the body. But I also think that being in that abusive relationship where I was dealing with so much stress, trauma, it just, my body couldn't cope. So that relationship lasted all in all for about 6 years. And pretty much the second that he was out of my life, I stopped having all of the fibromyalgia flare-ups that I would have. And it was amazing, and it just told me that my body was really trying to tell me something that I was just not listening to. And that was something that was pretty common throughout my life. I just wouldn't listen to my body. It would be trying to tell me all this stuff, and I was just so used to being in pain and being sick all the time that I didn't understand how much our bodies can really tell us. With all of my other issues, aside from fibromyalgia, I was still dealing with those things. And this was still at a time in my life where I didn't recognize that the diet that you eat has a big effect on exactly how your body functions. Once I started eating better and eating healthy whole foods, my body started feeling better. I wasn't dealing with so much of the pain from Crohn's that I would normally be having. And that was a really big deal for me. Once I started seeing that it was helping my stomach, I got really excited about living this lifestyle and eating healthy. Not only was it helping with some of the issues that I was having with Crohn's, but my cholesterol, which had been high, went down into normal levels, and I even was able to get off of my hypothyroidism medications. Now, I want to make it very clear, if you are hypothyroid, do not do that. Do not go off of the medication unless you have your doctor's approval. I had my doctor's approval. We had me tested before and after I went off the medications to make sure that it was okay. But that's not the case for people who actually need the medication. What I think happened with that is that I was in such a bad state for most of my life. You know, from the age of 8 to 19 when I got diagnosed with hypothyroidism, I didn't eat well at all, and I hardly moved around unless I had to. So my body was not in a good place. But once I got healthy and I started doing healthy activities and eating healthy, then I think that my body really reaped the benefits from that. And I was lucky enough to be able to go off of those medications. But if you actually have hypothyroidism or Hashimoto's, then please do not go off of the medication. That's a bit of my backstory in terms of my struggles with weight and health issues. Where I'm at now is in a much better place. I'm not struggling all the time with my stomach issues or with feeling terrible. I also feel happy with where my body is now. I'm not gonna lie and say that all of my problems are gone. I've had to accept the fact that I'm always going to have some issues, whether it's because of my back or because of Crohn's disease. But what I have found is that by eating a healthy diet, I feel so much better and I have a lot more control over the way that I feel as opposed to the past. Now, in terms of the future, I want to get to a place where my body composition is in a healthier state. And although I love my body as it is right now, I want to do whatever I can so that 50 years from now, when I'm 81 years old, I'm still able to do so many of the things that I love. I don't want to go back to the way that I was in the past because I know how unfulfilling that was. If you enjoyed this video or you feel like someone can benefit from it, then please share it with them.